हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। वेलकम टू द अनदर वीडियो ऑफ आरसीआई एजुकेशन हब बानसूर क्लास 11। लेट्स स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 4, एनिमल किंगडम। सो एज वी नो दैट लार्ज नंबर ऑफ एनिमल्स आर देयर, मिलियंस ऑफ स्पीसीज ऑफ एनिमल्स आर डिस्क्राइब्ड। सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट एनिमल्स आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सम सिस्टमेटिक वे। सो दीज एनिमल्स आर क्लासिफाइड on the given four major classifications are here. One, they can be classified on the basis of level of organization. Okay, if we discuss about the level of organization, so here animals are classified according to the cellular level of organization. It means here the single cell or some specific cells which work all the systematic way, and a single cell can perform all the various functions. After that, when these cells combine to perform a specific function, the level is known as tissue level of organization. Later on, this tissue combine to form organ, and organ combine to form organ system. So here animals are classified on the basis of level of organization. As we move ahead, complexity should be increased. Okay, if we discuss about the sponges, they having only cellular level of organization. It means they having a specific cell which perform all the metabolic activities of the body. Okay, whereas later on if we discuss about the cnidarians, then they perform their functions and they having a tissue level of organization. It means here the cells combine to form tissue. Okay, later on if we move ahead, platyhelminths, they show organ system level of organization. It means here the tissue combine to form different organs and these organs perform various functions. If we discuss about the another group, arthropoda, okay, they combine to form organ system level of organization. Okay, so this is about the level of organization. Now the second way to classify the animals is symmetry. What is the symmetry? So symmetry is a special thing about the animals, okay, on the basis of which their body can be divided into or not divided into two equal halves. So some animals are symmetrical whereas some are asymmetrical. If we discuss about the asymmetrical, symmetry defines that the body of the animal can be divided into two equal halves from one or more planes. So those animals which do not show this property, it means if we discuss about an organism which have the irregular shape, so we cannot divide it into two equal halves from any plane. It means these organisms are called asymmetrical. They cannot be divided into two equal halves, and all the sponges came under this category. Next, symmetrical. It means the organisms can be divided into two equal halves through one or more planes. So here the symmetrical, these organisms are divided into two types, bilateral symmetrical and radial symmetrical. If we discuss about the bilateral symmetrical, then by one plane body can be divided into two equal halves. It means the body can be divided into two equal halves only through a single plane. Okay, all the vertebrates, for example, if we discuss about the human beings, okay, then if we can divide them in between through the one plane, they can be divided into two equal halves. So this type of symmetry is known as bilateral symmetry. Okay, and all the vertebrates come under this category. Whereas radial symmetrical, the radial symmetrical, it means organisms can be divided into two equal halves through one or more planes. Okay, if the body can be divided divided into two equal halves through one or more plane, that type of symmetry is known as radial symmetry. Okay, so this type of symmetry mainly present in starfish, hydra, etc. So this is the second level of classification by which we can classify the animals into various groups. The third one which we discuss, germ layer. Okay, so generally there are two types of organisms on the basis of germ layers. The body organized through the ectoderm and endoderm. Mesoderm, and third one is endoderm. If the body comprised of two layers, ectoderm and endoderm, the organisms are known as diploblastic. The organisms are known as diploblastic. Okay, it means the organisms having the outermost germ layer. Okay, which is known as ectoderm. And then it is consist of inner layer, that is known as endoderm. Whereas there is no, or we can say that the mesoderm is absent. So this type of organisms are known as diploblastic. They having endoderm and ectoderm. Okay, so lower organisms like porifera, they all are diploblastic in nature. Whereas the organisms which are comprises of three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm, they are known as triploblastic. And all the higher organisms, arthropoda, vertebrata, they are consist of three germ layers and they are known as triploblastic. Okay. Is ectoderm, later on the another layer is mesoderm, and innermost layer is consist of endoderm. So when body consists of these three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm, the organisms are known as triploblastic. Here this layer which is present in between the ectoderm and endoderm is known as mesoglia. Okay, so this is the third basis on the behalf of which we classified the animals. The last one is body cavity. That we discuss in the next lecture. Okay, goodbye.